I told you after we were done with the Hulk, we would bring back Ghost Rider. Well, Johnny Blaze is here again, and this time he's going to be fighting the Beast of Sleepy Hollow, the Headless Horseman of Illinois. Yeah, just play the video. In the small town of Sleepy Hollow, the people enjoyed a nice quiet life. And on this night, the young man Cameron brings his date home. Or at least, that's what she thinks. As Cameron passes by Emily's house, Emily tells Cameron that he just missed the turn, and Cameron says that their date isn't over. Yet. He parks the car, and Emily says that she really needs to get home. Her dad will kill her if she doesn't. And Cameron gets out telling her that he's going to tell everyone at school that they did it. So she might as well go along with it. Once Cameron gets out of the car, Emily locks the doors, asking, "Please, just take me home. This isn't how I wanted the night to end." And suddenly there's a loud noise and a flash of light, and Emily grabs her phone, shouting, "I'm gonna call my dad!" However, as she looks back out the window, she sees Cameron standing there. And then he calls over. She gets out of the car and she screams as she looks at Cameron's decapitated head laying next to his body. The next morning, Sheriff Harry O'Connor, the godfather to Cameron, and an old partner's son, stops by the hospital to visit Emily. Harry asks how she's doing, and Harry's father tells him that they've been keeping her sedated. Just then she wakes back up screaming, trying to break the straps keeping her down, calling for her father. Tears fill the parents' eyes, seeing their daughter just like this, and Harry begins to undo the straps. Emily's mother says the nurse said not to, and then she stops, telling Harry, "Thank you." As the parents step out, Harry says to just give him 3 minutes. He'd like to talk to her alone. Once the door shuts, Harry leans back on the bed and he tells Emily, "I just want to tell you something. Cameron, he got himself into some trouble about a year ago when he tried to force himself onto a girl. That being said, it's completely okay to have defended yourself if..." But before he could finish, Emily tells him, "That's not what happened." And Harry sighs, stating, "Then just tell me what did happen." A short while later, as Harry leaves to investigate what happened, he receives a call from his golfing buddy, Archie. Harry answers, stating that he's a little busy at the moment, but Archie tells him, "Actually, we found the fella out here on the course. He's got no ID and there's blood all over his clothes." Harry spins back around and he heads over to the country club to find that man, who actually happens to be Johnny Blaze. As Harry pushes him into the locker room, he tells the other men that he's going to have a word with him in private. Harry then reaches into a locker, grabbing a golf club, and he says, "Those men must have really roughed you up, huh?" Johnny rubs his head, telling him, "What? No, those guys didn't do anything to me." And Harry tells him, "Yeah, sure they did," and he shuts the locker. Johnny asks, "Am I under arrest? Because if not, I'm gonna go." And Harry says, "You're free to try." And then he shouts, "Drop the weapon! Do it now!" Johnny asks him, "What are you talking about? I don't even have a..." But before he can finish, Harry hits him with a club. After a few more hits, Harry asks, "Where did the blood come from?" And Johnny tells him, "I'm not sure, I guess it's mine." And Harry tells him, "Wrong answer!" Then he hits him again and he asks, "What do you know?" Johnny looks up with fire in his eyes, stating, "If you keep beating me, something bad is going to happen, and I won't be able to stop it." Harry leans down, asking him, "Oh yeah? That's how it is? Gonna get all worked up and lose control? Is that when something bad happens?" At that moment, a fiery explosion goes off, knocking Harry to the ground, and the Ghost Rider stands up, telling him, "Yes!" Days later, Harry wakes up in the hospital bed, asking what happened. Another sheriff says actually they were hoping that he'd be able to tell them. Everything in that locker room was scorched. The only thing that didn't get burned was him. Harry picks himself up, grabbing his clothes, and the sheriff says that if he's planning on leaving, go through the back. The reporters are out front. There was another murder too, actually. Harry grits his teeth, asking, "Were there any witnesses?" And the sheriff says, "Yeah, several in fact. They all say that the man's head was on," and Harry pauses him. "Fire?" And the sheriff says, "Everything is just so weird, right?" But when he looks back, Harry's gone. Meanwhile, over at the Levins home, Mrs. Levins sits at a table where her husband had recently been killed, asking if they could please untie her so that she can pray. The seemingly dead jack-o'-lantern turns back, telling her, "Ma, I'm having a real busy day and I'm trying to watch some TV." Later that night, two young boys walk through the streets past curfew, but before they could get very far, they see a car coming. One of the boys runs through the woods, telling the others to just relax. It isn't a cop car, it only has one headlight, it's a motorcycle. The first boy stops and says, "Okay." And as the light gets closer, they see that this isn't a motorcycle at all, but it's Jack's flaming head coming right for them. As the boys get closer to the bridge, one jumps into the water, and shortly after, so does the second. The first boy grabs his friend's hand, and he begins to swim up to the shore, and after he pulls the body up, he notices his hands are all bloody. When he looks back, he sees that he's missing his head. Jack flies down, telling the boy, "I could've let him live, but it's gonna cost you your soul, do you?" The boy reaches out and a chain wraps around Jack, pulling the body away. The flaming head falls to the ground and he tells the boy, "We'll see each other again soon." As Jack's head returns to his body, he tells the Ghost Rider, "If you didn't notice, I was a bit busy back there." The Ghost Rider speeds off through a field, dragging Jack's body until he finally stops. The momentum launches Jack forward onto the street where there's a honking sound coming towards him. A second later, a semi-truck drives back, slamming into Jack, and his body is pulled underneath and driven by all 18 wheels. The truck driver jumps out of the cab and runs back asking, "What am I gonna do?" And the Ghost Rider tells him,
"You're gonna run very far away, now!"
As the truck driver rides off, Ghost Rider says,
"The slaughter of people ends tonight, Lucifer!"
Jack begins to laugh and he asks,
"You recognized my new costume, huh? Well, there's been some optional equipment that came along with this body."
Lucifer holds his arm out to reveal a wrist blaster and he fires it right into the Ghost Rider's head. The blast shatters the Ghost Rider's skull, and as it mends itself back together, Ghost Rider says,
"That was a nice try, devil! But you're only delaying the..."
Lucifer cuts him off.
"The inevitable?
Yeah, duh. But you want to know why?"
Jack's hoverboard flies over, knocking Ghost Rider in the head, and Lucifer jumps on it, yelling,
"Later on, bonehead!"
As the night goes on, Ghost Rider heads back in search of Lucifer when suddenly a cop car crashes into him. The car continues driving, and then it drives through a drugstore, pinning the Ghost Rider to the wall. Harry gets out of the car with a large gun, telling him,
"I'm not sure who you are, but this gun is more than enough to blow your head clean off, just like those kids."
Ghost Rider tells him,
"That wasn't me!"
And Harry asks him,
"So it must have been the other guy with the flaming head, right?"
Meanwhile, over the cemetery, Lucifer throws his arms up, yelling,
"I just love Sleepy Hollow. Who wants to go trick-or-treating?"
Suddenly, a hand shoots out of the graves nearby. As the night goes on, Lucifer arrives at a door and he rings the bell, telling everyone,
"Be quiet. You're going to ruin the surprise."
The lights inside turn on, and just as Lucifer says, "Trick or treat," a blast comes through the doorway and Harry reloads his shotgun. However, before our story got to that point, we must go back to the drugstore where Harry rammed into the Ghost Rider. Ghost Rider pulls himself up from the wreckage to answer Harry's question as to who he is.
"I am the spirit of vengeance. I am the Ghost Rider."
Harry points his gun, telling him,
"All right, just needed a name for the report is all."
But then the gun begins to melt and Ghost Rider stands up with the fires of hell burning around him. The chains wrap around Harry and Ghost Rider tells him,
"If you delay me again, I will show you punishment of biblical proportions."
Harry shouts, "If you're gonna kill me, you might as well do it now because I'm not gonna stop coming after you." Harry's then thrown from the building as it explodes, and he's left to watch as both the building and his car burns. Just as Harry goes to call it in, he sees Ghost Rider standing there and he asks him,
"What? Have you come to finish the job?"
Ghost Rider doesn't answer, and then he walks forward. Except Harry sees a transformation, and Johnny Blaze falls face first onto the ground. A short while later, Johnny opens his eyes, feeling ropes around him, asking,
"Where the hell am I?"
And Harry tells him,
"You're in my basement, and if you try to go off Flaming Skull, well..."
He then points to all the munitions stacked up behind him.
Harry says, "I don't care who you are, I just want to know what you are and why you're here."
Johnny takes a deep breath and he says his name is Johnny Blaze. A long time ago, he made the deal with the devil to save the ones that he loved. Because of that deal, he became the Ghost Rider and got sent to hell. He managed to escape, but so did the devil. But not in one piece, but in many pieces. Those pieces are scattered across the globe, and they've started bringing back people who died recently, possessed. Right now, I'm chasing the devil, trying to fix what I did. Any questions? Harry waits for a moment of silence, and then he asks,
"What's the devil look like anyway?"
Johnny thinks back, telling him,
"I can't remember."
And then the Ghost Rider shows an image of a flaming pumpkin. Harry thinks about it for a bit, and then he grabs his phone, calling his friend Ned to tell him,
"Look, I know someone dug up a grave a few days ago. Would it happen to have been Stephen Levins?"
Ned says, "Yeah, actually, now the whole cemetery's all dug up." Suddenly, a scream can be heard on the other line, and before Harry can do anything else, the call is disconnected. Johnny asks, "Who's Steve Levins?" And Harry explains that he was a local boy who went bad. He left here, went to New York, where he put on a costume and started killing people for money. Went by the name Jack-O-Lantern. Except he got his head blown off by that vigilante, the Punisher. Anyway, his parents had the body sent here to be buried, and it looks like he isn't buried anymore. Harry then goes to untie Johnny, and Johnny says, "Wait, you actually believe me?" Harry starts to gear up, telling him, "I've been an officer for a long time. Been in war twice. Suffice to say, nothing really surprises me anymore. So, if you're going after the devil, and one just popped up out of the ground for real, we should probably go kill it." Which brings us to the current time, where Harry has blown off Lucifer's head. Lucifer stands back up, telling the undead army,
"Don't just stand there! Attack!"
The undead shuffle their way up the stairs, and Harry shoots into each of them, shouting,
"Corpses are nothing to worry about. You're useless without orders."
Lucifer tells him,
"I already knew that part."
And Harry says, "I wasn't talking to you." Right behind Lucifer,
Ghost Rider walks up, pulling at his chain.
Lucifer looks around and he says, "Looks like we've been set up, boy."
And Ghost Rider tells him,
"Vengeance has covered you, devil!"
And Lucifer says, "Oh yeah, well you're stupid."
And he throws three pumpkin bombs. Ghost Rider throws his chain and Lucifer says, "Wow,
You really are stupid. Just as Harry gets done pushing a couch in front of the door, an explosion goes off, shaking the entire house. Lucifer shouts, I can't believe it. Do you know how hard it was for me to raise an entire zombie army? Do you even care? Back inside, Harry gets ready to call it in when he sees someone walking towards him. Cameron. Outside, Ghost Rider and Lucifer hear Harry scream, and Lucifer says, looks like the sheriff just got reunited with his long-lost godson. So glad he happened to make it. Ghost Rider calls out, Harry! And Lucifer tells him, wait, I'm standing right here, and you're concerned with that guy? Really? I am very disappointed in you, Ghost Rider. Ghost Rider stares and he throws his chain, telling him, shut up! But before the chain could reach Lucifer, the hoverboard shoots by, getting caught in the chains, flying into the air with the Ghost Rider. Lucifer calls out, telling him, you should take this time to think about what's important to you and get those priorities in line. As the hoverboard shoots into the sky, the Ghost Rider pulls himself onto it. With all of his strength, he pulls on the chain until it rips down the middle of the board, and he begins to fall back down to the earth. Off in the distance, a low rumble can be heard, and the Ghost Rider's bike drives up onto a car and into the air. Ghost Rider then grabs onto the handlebars, revs the engine, and he races back to the ground. Back inside of the house, Harry grabs a fork, telling Cameron, I don't want to stab you with this, but... Cameron lunges forward, and even with Harry stabbing him, he turns back and grabs Harry by the throat. Harry pushes him, shouting, that's it! You were a bad kid, you always were! Cameron continues to push forward, but this time Harry kicks him into the refrigerator, telling him, if you hadn't been killed, you probably would have ended up killing somebody else. The refrigerator rocks, and then it falls onto the boy. Harry holds the refrigerator as Cameron tries pushing it off, and then he stays there until the thumping finally stops. But then Lucifer steps in, telling him, this may have been a bit of a surprise, but I have never fired a gun. All I have to do is point at what I want dead and pull the trigger, right? Harry tells him, that's right, but you gotta put bullets in it first. Lucifer looks at the gun to check, and then a chain wraps around his foot and he's pulled away. The shotgun falls to the ground, going off, and Lucifer laughs, shouting, ha ha, you got me, Harry! Harry gets back up, telling him, no, I didn't. We did. Ghost Rider drags Lucifer through the house until he gets him into the trap, a room full of explosives. The entire house explodes in a fiery blaze, and the Ghost Rider walks right back out of it. Lucifer picks himself up, telling him, this is a drag. I actually liked this outfit. Without saying a word, the Ghost Rider shoves his arm into Lucifer's chest, pulling out his beating heart. He holds the heart up, setting it on fire, and then he puts it back into Lucifer's chest. Lucifer stumbles back, and his heart explodes, spraying fire everywhere. His head falls off of his shoulders, and then the Ghost Rider stomps on it, crushing the pumpkin into pieces. With Lucifer taken care of, Johnny Blaze changes back, and he goes to check on Harry, who hid in the basement. He asks if anything's wrong, and Harry shouts, asking, what's wrong is that I'm 62 damn years old. Johnny tells him, look, I wanted to thank you for... But before he can say another word, Harry tells him that you can thank me by getting the hell out of my town and never coming back, ever. And so, Johnny Blaze gets back on his motorcycle and he leaves the once quiet town of Sleepy Hollow. And there you have it, another Johnny Blaze Ghost Rider storyline. Now we're going to be bringing you a few of these over the next couple of weeks to wrap up the Daniel Way storyline of the Ghost Rider, where he hunts down the devil. Let me know what you think about the classic Ghost Rider, the one on the motorcycle, the one with the chain, the one named The Blaze. Let me know what you think of that, and I will see you next time right here at Comic Story. And subscribe to get the next video on Sunday.